Hi, this is Roger Hamilton with this month's monthly update from Paris. Vegas. We have just finished the Las Vegas Wealth Dynamics experience, which has been an amazing experience, and especially because not only is it the beginning of the Wealth Dynamics experience here in America, it also happened during a week that we'll remember as the week when the crisis in Wall Street turned a corner. This was the week when we had the Fed get a $700 billion bailout. This was the week when we heard of some of the biggest financial institutions fall over. And by the time you hear this, there'll be much more news that is taking place as well. What does it all mean for us within Worldwide Wealth and for entrepreneurs around the world? I was in Asia in 1997 during the Asian crisis. People had written China off, and 10 years later, China is now one of the most powerful nations in the world. And I've lived in Bali. We moved there in 2002, which was when we had the Bali bomb. And 5 years later, the economy in Bali is bigger than ever. Here we are in Vegas, and we are at the beginning of a new chapter. Because it's in fact, while we've been here, that we have seen entrepreneurs in America connect with entrepreneurs all around the world. We have some 22 countries who came to the event here. And after the last month, when we've had the Entrepreneur Business School, when we have had the leader meeting with all of our leaders around the world meeting up, we have seen the world continue to shrink in size by the way that we're able to connect all around the world. The smaller the world becomes, the bigger our life becomes. And now, as I head off to the airport to England, where we have a tour, over four or five different cities this week, and then after that I will be having a tour in New Zealand. As I travel around the world, I see the entrepreneurs start to really step up into a new space. You see, this week not only did we have all the news about the crisis, this was also the week that we had some other news which is going to change the world. It was a Clinton Global Initiative this week, and so while the two presidential nominees were debating for the first time, they also were on stage together pledging a halving of poverty by 2015, an end to malaria within the coming years, and pledges including $3 billion by Bono and by Bill Gates to be able to not just rid the world of malaria, but other diseases and AIDS, and for all of us around the world, having the right medical care, having the right education. These were not covered in the news in the same way that the crisis were, but they're going to impact all of us towards 2020 and towards United Nations Millennium Goals. Plus, always in times of crisis are the times of greatest opportunity. So this was also the week that we had, for the first time, Google come out with their new phone. It was for the first time that we had General Motors Chevy come out with Volt, which is their electric car. The first car registered for over 100 miles per gallon in commercial production. This is also the week where XL launched the XL iPhone. You're going to hear much more about the iPhone in the coming weeks and months, and I'm now going to leave you with a clip which tells you exactly what it is.
Thank you. Thank you.